Welcome back. That pumpkin making was a lot of fun, as was the lip glue.
Yes, both riveting. I'm glad we've toned down a little.
Made for great television. Going back to an earlier conversation, speaking of lips, tell us about this little invention you found.
Well, you know, I have this thing, and I mentioned it earlier, that I enjoy when people try to sell me something on the internet, and I believe I have to have it. That's why I enjoy it.
What's the worst thing you've ever purchased from the internet?
I purchased a product called Go Girl. I'm not sure. Have you ever heard of this?
I have not.
Okay, so Go Girl is a product that is marketed to women who would like to pee standing up. Mm-hmm. So it's basically a cup, a silicone cup that forms into a funnel. And I sprung a little extra to get a 18-inch extension tube to really whiz out there.
You know, an 18-inch extension to any male who stands up peeing is like a dream come true.
Well, I purchased it in lavender.
How much does 18 inches cost you?
I paid $17.99 for this creation. And I was hunting. So if you've ever squatted in the woods as a girl, it's terrible. It's like the worst ever. So I thought, standing up, this is fantastic. I don't have to search for a place to go. They market this as sort of you can conceal it and no one would see you.
So would you take it to like a sporting event?
That's what they say. Okay. Take it to your kid's soccer game and Wizzerino right on the sidelines. No one's going to know. I feel like this is false. I'm not sure if anyone could possibly use this in secret.
Can I ask one question before you go on?
Please.
Yeah. So if you have an 18-inch extension at a soccer game,
you probably wouldn't bring.
Nobody's going to notice. I mean, if I whipped out 18 inches, I'm pretty sure the whole sideline would be questioning what I'm doing.
We wouldn't be here, honey. It'd be in a whole different career.
Right?
But the moral is you probably aren't using the extension at Johnny's soccer game.
We'll back that up.
I was going to try to use it in the hunting situation. So I decided to practice the night before.
It's a good idea.
Yeah, I felt like that's probably good, right? Get to know how the product works and see if it's as easy as advertised. The moral is, I just peed my pants, actually. I'm not sure who can pee into this teeny tiny, from what I can gather, size of a quarter that you're going to have to get it into. And you have to, like, cup it into your lady bits. This is not a great product. I'm giving it 0 out of 5 stars. Would not pee in it again is how I feel if I was giving it a real review.
That is a great rating. Get back into life with Depends.
Yeah, that would have been better, actually.
So did you take it hunting? Choice.
No, I actually just peed in a bucket.
Oh, that's classy.
Top notch.
Right. Great job. So what was this hunting adventure all about? Tell us more.
I am a huntress. I don't know if that's the right word.
I kind of like it.
Yeah, yeah. I have been hunting with my dad since I was, my gosh, 9. I think I tagged along. And, you know, for people who are anti-hunting, I understand everybody's viewpoint, but for me,
she's not talking giraffes, elephants, gorillas, endangered species.
No, I'm talking white-tailed deer. And growing up in Wisconsin, general redneckery all over the place. Mm-hmm. This was a way for my sister and I to bond with my dad, because this is really his passion and where he shines. And the fact that he showed us everything that he knows, and we could spend that time, and it's just time, right? It's all about time and memories. It's never about killing a deer.
Right.
And now the fact that I get to share that with my kids and teach them all the things that I learned at my parents is magical. What's not magical is peeing in a Go Girl while you're with your kid hunting.
That's I'm sure magical. That was a lot of fun.
It was great.
And to explain for our friends in New York City, LA, Austin, you know, any large city, white-tailed deer are a plethora in the upper Midwest, specifically Wisconsin and Minnesota.
Yeah.
So there's actually an overpopulation. So part of the hunting is to A, control the population, and B, to consume the meat that you actually gain through your hunt. So I know a lot of people are really against hunting. They're really anti-gun. And what we really want to point out here is that we do consume what we hunt.
Yes.
And to us, hunting is a ritual. It's an experience. It's time with family and friends.
Yeah.
Is that correct? I've never been hunting.
No, it's 1,000% correct. There are very few activities that I think a parent can say they spend time with their kid mm-hmm. that has zero screen time. It's undivided and you're in nature. And, you know, I am so thankful every year that I get that chance. And mm-hmm. it wasn't until I got older that I realized how special it was with my dad when I was younger. And I hope that my kids see the same thing. So, yeah. Oh, that was very heartwarming.
It totally was.
Oh, I love
it. We had a moment on our first show.
It was like a very, that was a moment.
I feel like we need to hug, but yeah. I'm not much of a hugger. So
we'll just do that maybe.
I can't even fist bump because when I do it, my wrist is limpy.
Oh, yeah, I have a hyperextended elbow, so maybe we could work that into a thing.
What just happened
there?
If
I was a cheerleader, I'd have been like, why? Why are we winning? Because of me. Anyway.
And when we come back, we're going to talk about stalking your neighbors.
Yeah, how do you creep on them? Come back and see.
I prefer binoculars. We'll be right back.